What is up, amigos? Today we're talking about this car here. This is called a Mercedes Benz T80. And this is a experimental car. It was made in 1939. And the reason why I like it so much is because it's one of the first cars, or it's really the first car, that has all these very prominent aerodynamic features. And this was built to break land speed records. So this was 8 meters long, and it had a 44.5 liter engine, which produced 2,200 kilowatts. And it reached a top speed of about 600 k's per hour. That was the targeted one, and then they wanted to go higher as well, but the production was cancelled on that. So today we're going to go through all these different features, and there isn't actually a lot of information on this car, despite how many features there are. But in terms of what there is out there and some automotive aerodynamic knowledge, we can go through these different features and talk about what they do and why. So the first thing to keep in mind is this was built for speed, so we need to have as low a drag coefficient as possible. So first of all, the drag coefficient of this thing, you can't really see too much on here, but it's 0.18. So to give you some perspective, that is in 1939. To look at cars these days, so if you were to go out and just buy a regular car, on average, that car will have a drag coefficient of about 0.26 to 0.28. So this is a third less than that already, and this was 90 years ago, or 80 years ago. So that's how aerodynamic this thing is. But it's not just about drag reduction, it's also about downforce reduction, because as you go faster, you want to have downforce keep you on the road and not lose control. So let's go through a bunch of these different features to discuss what's happening. So the first thing we have is the enclosed cockpit. So the driver in there, he or she is not going to be seeing the flow, so that is now reducing the drag there by letting the flow go around this predefined shape, which is quite streamlined. Second, we see these wings, which is really the most prominent feature on the car, really. And from this perspective, it doesn't really look like too much. They just look like little plates coming out. But from this perspective, we can really see now that these wings, first of all, are sort of tilted up, and they're also cambered. That means that these are producing downforce, and they also do produce some sideways stability. What else do we have here? Well, if we look at the wheels, we see that all these wheels here are completely enclosed, and that is very good for drag, because drag from the wheels typically account for about 30% of the car's total drag. And this car actually had 6 wheels, so that's 50% more drag there as well. So in this picture, you can kind of see 2 wheels at the back here, so 2 axles, and then the one at the front, that's where the 6 wheels come in. So covering all these wheels dramatically reduces drag. It's just like if you were to completely cover the rims, and if you go to like the 1950s cars, for example, when you have these like the hubs mostly covered, that's kind of what this looks like. But this was way before that anyway, so this was a real masterpiece. So that reduces the drag there. Another thing we have is the front. So you see the bonnet here? It's not like a regular car, where it's a regular car these days is quite blocky. This one is much more streamlined, it's much sleeker. So that means that the air coming on the front here is not hitting this very blunt object, it's hitting this quite like sharp front, and then that then goes over the car and reduces the drag that way. And then that can be funneled around the cockpit as well. Now, in terms of the rear, this is quite interesting, and also the cockpit, we see the same kind of feature happening among all these features, the same kind of idea. So back on to this picture here, we see that the cockpit starts to blend quite a lot into the body of the car, and then the two like vertical fins that house the wheels also kind of blend a little bit more into the body as we go downstream. That is for a couple of reasons. First of all, it's for drag reduction. So we do get a lot of drag because it's not just this abrupt drop in terms of this cross-sectional area. It reduces quite gradually. The second thing is that with these two rear vertical fins, we get some sideways stabilities, and especially during corners. And finally, we do see a diffuser at the back here, but it's not nearly as similar as a regular car. So if you look at the back on this car, it is very sharp, and that is very good for drag reduction, because the back of the car on regular cars these days is pretty much the main producer of drag. You have such a flat, big back that and has a low pressure there, that just results in a lot more drag being formed, because the front has high pressure, back has low pressure. That's pressure drag being pushing the car backwards. Because we have such a small back here, we don't get that. We might have a small low pressure here, but even still, this is very streamlined, so the flow would be converging quite nicely here. There wouldn't really be any flow separation, so there wouldn't really be much low pressure here anyway. So that is going to reduce the drag dramatically, and you have the diffuser as well, which sort of funnels the flow nicely and converges with the flow from the top here. And at the back here, these two fins also sort of converge in quite sharply as well. So those are the major features of this car and why this is my favorite car. You can actually find it in Stuttgart. And if you are ever in Stuttgart, you should go to the Mercedes-Benz Museum and look at this car. It's really cool to see in real life as well. The pictures are cool, but seeing in real life is even better. And I want you to go through this because of all the different aerodynamic features that we can see here. So that's the interview. If you'd like to, make sure to like, subscribe, and I'll see you soon. Peace and amigos.